What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. So ASUS launched their BIOS 330 for the ROG Ally, and I decided to take a look at some comparisons of the BIOS 323 that I was running prior. I'm basically going to use benchmarks throughout this video. I mean, there's one game in particular that gave me some pretty interesting results that we'll see throughout the video, but we'll look at some pieces of benchmarks here, and then we'll take a look at some average frame rates, and we'll just kind of talk about what we see here. Now, for the most part, we actually don't see a lot of difference, but let's start off with Motorsport here. And all of the settings have been matched for everything. So 25 watt, 15 watt, just running at the same settings and resolution, and 4 gigabytes of VRAM all around here on the Ally right now for running these tests. And as we start off with Motorsport here, 25 watts with those settings, you'll see that for the most part, as we're running here, the frame rate is almost going to match identically. We do get difference in the amount of total RAM being used. I noticed that in all the games we're going to take a look at here in the benchmarks, the VRAM will pretty much match, but we'll get a difference as far as our clocks go for our GPU and how that's being worked and how our RAM in general, the total is there, and the frame times a little bit. Other than that, it seems to hit pretty much similar FPS at 33 FPS average achieved here with this. But if you look at all the individual numbers, there's quite a difference in how the game's actually performing under these BIOS. And if we take a look at 15 watts, which of course this game isn't recommended to run that way at 1080p, but again, similar situation here where, you know, VRAM often is about the same and everything, but the amount of actual RAM usage and some of the variations in frame times and just how the game is running in general do vary a bit more than over on 323. And we do need a GPU driver update. I think this BIOS is actually pretty good so far, minus some of the bugs and things I've been reading about. But as far as performance, it hasn't seemed to really bork too much, at least in these games. 25 and 24 there. But again, if you look at the individual numbers, there are some areas where 323 is doing better than 330. But again, I do think a lot of that could be cleaned up with just better GPU drivers being updated for us here. Take a look at Assassin's Creed Mirage. This is one I've played a lot on the Ally. And as we get into this one at 25 watts here, you'll see that for the most part, it runs the same as well. But that same variation of like GPU usage, the amount of RAM, and sometimes frame times. However, in Mirage, the frame times are much closer. The game's smoothness is a lot closer than what Motorsport was offering. So it can be a little deceiving just looking at frame rate, because there really is a good bit of difference happening in the background with the way these games are running here. And as far as average FPS though, 52 and 51, a little bit different when it comes to our min-max, but this in-game benchmark Ubisoft has here is pretty rough and sometimes broken in Mirage, but it works for our purposes here for 323 versus 330. Now we get into the 15 watts here, and this game actually runs fairly decently, even at 1080p at 15 watts, until you get into real world gameplay. But you'll see those similar differences here at 15 as well that we saw with everything else. It's pretty consistent across the board, although I will say this is the time that the RAM actually matched the closest for all the tests here, running at 15 watts on Assassin's Creed Mirage, which I found kind of interesting. Now, as far as the averages though, 40-40, and not a lot of difference in those, but again, the way the game is actually running though is a good bit different in the background when we take a look at that. Now, we'll take a look at Mortal Kombat. This one is actually probably the most interesting for difference when it comes to how this performed. At 25 watts, as we get into here, 323 actually runs quite a bit better than 330 on Mortal Kombat. And this just tells me, just like any other test, different games are going to perform differently. Motorsport and Assassin's Creed Mirage had their differences. 15 watts actually matched RAM pretty closely. 25 watts in Mortal Kombat, 323 actually has a noticeable improvement when it comes to performance. And again, a GPU driver update's probably going to solve most of those issues for us here. 54 and 51 as far as the averages, but there were some bigger differences than that if you just pause and look at individual gameplay sections. Now at 15 watts here on Mortal Kombat, we see a similar story with performance and 323 outperforming 330, and frame times of course are a good bit better. And while I wouldn't play this game at all this way anyway, it does give me an idea again of what kind of performance differences we're seeing between the two BIOS. And it's just each game here I've shown, even with these consistent benchmarks, does point out something and some kind of difference between the two. And a lot of the times it is leaning toward 323, but again, with a new BIOS like this, we are going to need those new GPU drivers, which you've heard me say quite a few times in this video, because I do want some updates to that soon. 37, 35 when it comes to our averages though there. Now, let's take a quick look at in-game. I don't have a benchmark here for RoboCop Rogue City, Unreal Engine 5, but I thought I would jump into just a little bit of a few seconds here of this game, and it ran actually very consistent between the two. Even like frame times, frame rate, just the way the game looked and ran here. This was probably one of the more consistent experiences between the two, which I thought was interesting here with this demo for RoboCop running Unreal 5, and just interesting to take a look at it and see how it was running compared to the other in-game benchmarks that we were looking at. But I think this video actually gives a pretty decent idea and insight, especially if you do some pausing and looking around throughout the video, of what kind of performance differences there are just currently on 323 and 330 for the BIOS. And I think, again, that a lot of that's just going to be cleaned up when we do get an updated GPU driver, as AMD has updated their drivers quite a few times since our ROG Ally driver has been updated. I'm sure ASUS is working on an update for our GPU driver so that we can run a lot of these games better on 330 and just better in general and that type of thing. Because I have seen, you know, when you sideload the newer drivers, a lot of times those can gain you some performance. But for those of us just trying to run the machine mainstream and keep it going here with official stuff from ASUS, we are waiting on an update for that. All right, guys, thanks a lot for coming to check out the video. As always, I really appreciate it, and I'll see you in the next one.